The 10 most dangerous hiking trails in America. There are many different aspects of hiking that can make a long walk through the wilderness go south. Heat, wild animals, and dangerous terrain can contribute to making what was supposed to be a nice, peaceful stroll into a life-threatening situation. However, this doesn't stop many thrill seekers from taking their chances with some of the most dangerous hiking trails all across the United States. Whether it's climbing through 60-mile-an-hour winds in sub-zero temperatures, or standing atop an active volcano, backpackers across the world have proven they have no fear. So throw on your backpack, grab a cliff bar, and get ready to go on an adventure through some of the most dangerous hiking trails in the United States. Before we begin, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to our channel. Now, here are the 10 most dangerous hiking trails in America. At number 10, there's Abrams Falls. The hike to Abrams Falls in the Great Smoky Mountains of Tennessee can be incredibly dangerous. Since 1936, roughly 60 people have succumbed to hypothermia or drowned while trekking through the perilous trail. The trek takes backpackers through heavily wooded areas with lush green forests and beautiful country. However, the beauty of the scene does not come without dangers. The Abrams Fall Trail is made up of strong waters that often swell due to storms in the area and can sweep away unsuspecting hikers and swimmers, dragging them down to the depths of the waterfall. The hike to Abrams Falls and back clocks in at just over 5 miles, making it one of the shorter hikes on this list, but just as dangerous as any other. Needless to say, if you enjoy taking a break from hiking and going for a dip, this is definitely not the place for that. Number 9, The Maze. Nicknamed The Maze, this trail through Canyonlands National Park in Utah is the most dangerous trek in the state. As you may have guessed from the nickname, the canyons and trails that make up the hike can lead to dead ends, making it hard to reach the other side. On top of this, there are not many vantage points where travelers could make out nearby landmarks, leaving people stranded as they try to find the correct pathways to follow. The trail is over 100 miles away from any kind of civilization. Most trips to the maze take about 3 to 7 days to complete, so hikers have to bring essentials as well as enough food and water for any kind of emergency. Help could take up to 3 days to arrive. The sheer remoteness of the location should be enough to scare away any sane person, but it doesn't stop 2,000 thrill seekers from making the journey each year. Only experienced backpackers with strong navigation skills can make this long journey. GPS doesn't always work on the trail, so using a map and a compass is the best option for anyone brave enough to take a trip to this puzzling no man's land. And I'm definitely not. After that movie 127 Hours, I doubt you'll ever see me hiking in Utah. Number 8, Huckleberry Mountain. Clocking in at 11.3 miles in length, Montana's Huckleberry Mountain Trail is a beautiful hike known for its lush forests, wildflowers, and how could we forget ferocious grizzly bears? And it's not just a few grizzlies either. A recent study showed as many as 563 bears living on the mountain. That would make 0.35 bears per each square mile. Based on that fact, it's no surprise that 10 people have been killed by bears in the area since 1967. And many more have had scary encounters with them. During huckleberry season, park rangers usually close off the area because of the high number of bears that move through the mountain looking for food. However, they allow hikers to take the trail at night during these high bear activity timeframes. Regardless of how experienced of a hiker you are, I don't think anyone would fare well against a hungry bear that just woke out of hibernation. In any case, if I was going to hike up a mountain, I would at least bring some bear mace. Number 7, Bar Trail. Pikes Peak in Colorado is said to create a perfect combination of factors that attracts lightning bolts to its 14,000 foot peak. The height of the summit mixes the moist winds of southern Colorado with the turbulent winds of the plains, creating a perfect storm of characteristics that has shocked, pun intended, 22 backpackers since the year of 2000. As the state of Colorado has the highest elevation of any other province in America, it should come as no surprise that it also ranks as one of the states with the most lightning strikes, second only to Florida of all places. Travelers of Bar Trail can expect a 13-mile one-way hike all the way through, and are told to get off the mountain as soon as they see clouds forming. Storms and rain clouds can form very quickly at high altitudes, and you wouldn't want to be caught here during a thunderstorm. Better be sure to check the weather radar before planning your family vacation here. Number 6, Bright Angel Trail. The dangers of Bright Angel Trail in Arizona's Grand Canyon are not lightning or even wildlife related. Nope, the biggest hazard of this trail has to do with sheer temperature. During the summer months, the canyon's trails regularly reach up to 130 degrees Fahrenheit, leaving backpackers dehydrated during its 9.5 mile trek. Fun fact, the human brain begins to damage at 120 degrees Fahrenheit, 10 degrees less than the hottest temperature in the canyon. Yikes. The heat, along with the 4,380 vertical feet it takes to walk from rim to river and back, makes it one of the most dangerous hiking trails in the United States. If you don't believe me, just look at the 200 cases of heat-related rescues in the park each year. When many travelers reach the high temperatures, they begin pushing themselves to try to get out of the breathtaking heat as fast as possible. However, this can be a fatal mistake, speeding up the process of their heat-related illness. The Grand Canyon is one of the world's most famous wonders, making Bright Angel Trail a hiker's dream. The recommended time to take this trail is just before dawn and return during the evening, while making sure to rest frequently throughout the journey. Number 5, Devil's Path. Located just 2 hours away from New York City, Devil's Path is said to be one of the most beautiful trails in the United States. That being said, the sights of this trail don't come without peril. The trek's climb and descent of 14,000 feet are stretched across a 25-mile long hike, making it the longest trail on this list. The path is made up of slippery rocks and steep mountain slides, as well as being home to a small group of black bears. Hikers also have to worry about nighttime temperature drops that make the path wet and icy. However, by the end of the 1 to 2 day hike, you will have climbed your way through flowery mountain falls, steep peaks, and deep valleys, as long as you make it there in one piece. I'm not sure if I'm prepared for even a 25-mile long walk, let alone a 25-mile hike up a mountain. Number 4, Muir Snowfield Trail. This moderately short, 9-mile trek through Mount Rainier in Washington is an unmarked climb of 2,800 feet. Backpackers hoping to make it through run into Muir Snowfield, a 2.5-mile stretch of uphill trail covered in snow. While the snow in itself can be dangerous, if the proper precautions are not taken, the real danger of this hike comes in the form of rapidly forming snowstorms. The storms often come from the Pacific and leave unsuspecting hikers cold, wet, and fatigued. These environmental factors all likely contributed to the 90 climbers who have either slipped or frozen to death on the mountain. As if it could get any worse, Mount Rainier is also an active volcano, so if the freezing to death wasn't enough to scare you away, then maybe the possibility of a volcano erupting at any given moment will. Mount Rainier is widely considered the deadliest mountain in the US. Number 3, Mount McKinley. The summit of Mount McKinley can easily be one of the coldest points on Earth. Coming in at about 20,320 feet tall, the freezing cold temperatures and thin air make it a very dangerous trail to climb. So dangerous, in fact, that 50 to 75 climbers require help on their way up to the mountain each year. The steep slopes, icy edges, and crumbling avalanches are just some of the few dangers hikers face on their trip up the mountain. In fact, so many people need to be rescued on a regular basis that the Park Service and the military collectively spent $431,345 on saving climbers and retrieving bodies from McKinley last year. Apparently, taxpayers in the area are not too happy with having to pay for these kinds of expenses, and don't believe it's the government's job to save these climbers in distress. Jeez. Number 2, Mist Trail. Located in California's famous Yosemite National Park, Mist Trail takes backpackers on a 7-mile route through mostly rocky and steep terrain to the 8,836 feet high Half Dome. Near the summit of the Half Dome, there is a steep 400-foot ascent to climb with cables to assist. However, even with the cables, the last stretch to the top requires strength and determination. The rocky terrain can also get very slippery during rain or winter seasons, which is when the majority of falls happen. The park's search and rescue team responds to an average of 250 incidents each year, more than any other national park. Maybe that's not something to brag about, I don't know. While only 13 deaths have been recorded since the park was established, that doesn't stop the Half Dome from being one of the most hazardous trails in America, or from hauling in 50,000 hikers on a yearly basis. And at number one, there's Mount Washington. Mount Washington in New Hampshire is widely known as the most dangerous small mountain in the world. Extremely strong winds mixed with extreme colds make this trek easily the most dangerous entry on this list. Don't let the small size fool you. This trek has seen 150 fatalities since 1849, many of them due to freezing temperatures. The 6,288-foot mountain is a part of the White Mountains, nicknamed this because of the year-round snow that encases the summit. 60-mile-an-hour winds are common on the trail, and often push backpackers off track, putting them in danger. If hikers end up walking with the wind, they could end up miles away from any pathway that could get them back to safety. Getting lost in cold weather usually never ends well. This small mountain is not for the faint of heart, and it can just be as deadly as Mount Rainier, with the strong winds and the vicious, fast-moving snowstorms. Were you at all surprised by any of the hiking spots on this list? And do you think you're brave enough to attempt one of these treks? Make sure to let me know in the comments. And before you leave, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.